Hey Premiere Pros, it's Paul Murphy here, and are you editing a lot of remote interviews with Premiere Pro? Well, today I'm going to talk about why you should be recording those interviews with Riverside FM. So this video is sponsored by Riverside, but I've been using their platform for a long time now. And whenever a client comes to me and says they want to record a remote interview, I always recommend Riverside because A, the quality is very high, and B, as an editor, it makes my job much easier. And you can get a basic Riverside account for free, but they're also offering 15% off membership if you use the link and coupon code in the description below. So I'm going to start by talking about some of my recommended settings for working with Riverside. Then we're going to look at how to get those files from Riverside into Premiere Pro for editing. And then at the end, we're going to do some quality tests on those recorded files. So let's jump over to our studio in Riverside here. And basically a studio is where you do all of your recordings in Riverside. And there are just a couple of settings that you'll want to change before you start recording. So I'm going to go down to the bottom left here and click settings. And then I'm going to go over to the recording tab. So by default, the audio sample rate will usually be set to 44.1, which is fine for audio podcasts. But if you're working with video, it's better to set this to 48 kilohertz because that's better for syncing audio with video. And then underneath that, we can set the resolution of the recorded video. The recommended setting is optimized quality, which will record up to 720p. But if you have a camera that can handle 1080p or even 4K, you can go over here and turn on the advanced quality. And you do have to set whether you're going up to 1080p or if you're going up to 4K HD. If you're interviewing someone who doesn't have a very powerful computer, I would recommend going with the optimized quality setting. And the only other setting that I want to talk about here is the use noise reduction setting. And I've done some tests on this, which I'll show you at the end of the video. And I've actually found that this built-in noise reduction is quite good. And I would say if you're the sort of person who is happy to take an audio file into something like Adobe Audition and remove noise there, I would turn this off. But otherwise, I do find that the results are quite good if you leave it on, and probably better than using something like the denoiser in Premiere Pro. Now, when it comes time to inviting guests to join you in Riverside, all you need to do is send them a link to your studio and they can connect through a browser, so Chrome or Microsoft Edge. If they want to connect on a phone or another device, they can use the Riverside app, which is available on both iOS and Android. Now, I do have a couple of guests waiting to join me in the lobby here, so I'm going to let them in. And what I really like about the interface here is that I can see what camera and microphone that they're using on their computer. So for example, if I've sent them a specific microphone that I wanted them to use in that recording, I can see here whether they're actually using that microphone or not. And I can also monitor their levels down here so I can see whether I'm getting a strong signal or not. I do have this volume slider, but that's just going to control what I can hear. So if somebody's not coming in quite strong enough, they need to change the input settings on their computer, not on that slider there. And then when you're ready to start recording, just click record. Now, the image that you're seeing may look a bit blurry on the screen, but that's because the way that Riverside actually works is it's not recording over the internet. It's recording on each individual guest computer and then uploading that recording over the internet. And I can see here under each guest name how much of their video file has been uploaded. And then when you finish recording, you can press stop. Make sure that your guests stay around until their upload has finished. If the guest does jump off the call before they finish their upload, you can send them to this link here and it will finish the upload for them. And so now if I want to see my finished files, I'm going to go to my dashboard where I can see all of my studio recordings. And I can see here is an individual track for Charlotte and Angela, and they each have their own high quality video and high quality audio. And now I need to get these files over to Premiere Pro, get them in sync and edit them all together. And this is probably the number one reason why I like working with Riverside is they make this process very, very easy for Premiere Pro editors. All I need to do is go up to the export button up here and I'm going to choose export to Adobe Premiere Pro. And I can just download all of those files already added to their own timeline. So here I've downloaded all of those files as a zip file. I will unzip that. And inside of that folder are all the files that I need, but I just need this XML file. I'll go over to Premiere Pro and I'll drag that XML file into my project file. Here we have a timeline with all of our files already together, already in sync. And so up here, we have the individual high quality video tracks. Underneath that, we have the audio from the video tracks. And you don't want to use the audio from the video because it's not as high quality as this separate audio here. And now we can start cutting between these two video tracks to create our remote interview. Now, I did say we're going to do a quality test on Riverside's recorded files. And for that, I thought a good comparison would be using something recorded using Zoom. And you can see I've got two video recordings stacked on top of each other here. I've got the Riverside one and the Zoom test. I've actually had to scale up the Zoom test because although I set this to HD, it's come in at 720p, whereas the Riverside recording has come in at 1080p. So it's already higher quality in that regard. Now looking at this image out of Zoom, it's not too bad. I'm using my webcam, so it's already affecting the quality a bit. If I compare this to Riverside, you can see that Riverside is maybe looking a little washed out, and maybe that doesn't sound like a good thing. But what that actually means is I have a lot more control over this image out of Riverside. If I show you my Lumetri scopes, where we can look at the luma of the image, you can see in Riverside, I've got a lot of detail in the shadows here. So when it comes time to color grading this and maybe trying to brighten it up a bit more, I'll have a lot more information to work with. Whereas if you look at the image out of Zoom, it's actually crushing a lot of the blacks down here. And trying to brighten this up, I'm going to bring up a lot of noise with that as well. And let's just do a quick comparison of the files as well. I'm going to bring up media info, which I always use when I want to get the data on a particular video. And I'm going to drag the Zoom test in here. You can see that our bit rate is 628 kilobits, so it's less than a megabit per second. And of course, it's 1280 by 720. And if I grab that Riverside file and drag that in, you can see we're more than twice the bit rate here, and we're coming in at 1920 by 1080. So we've definitely got a better video recording of my webcam, but I find that the real shining light of Riverside is its audio quality. And to show you the difference between audio quality, I'm going to jump over to Adobe Audition. Here I have my Riverside recording of my audio. Okay, so I'm recording in both Riverside and Zoom, and let's put these. And I'm looking at this in a spectral frequency display. So I'm looking at all of my frequencies in the recording. You can see I've got my low frequencies down here, high frequencies up the top. And what I like about this is there's a nice smooth gradient in this recording, and it goes all the way up to 23K. And there's a lot of nice presence in somebody's voice up here. Now, if I compare this to the Zoom audio, you can see it's clamping this off at about 12K. And also there's a lot less of a smooth gradient in the audio signal, which means if I try to improve the sound of this with EQ or something like compressor, it's not going to sound as good. And certainly you can hear the difference between these two just by playing them back as well. Okay, so I'm recording in both Riverside and... So you can hear that one sounds a lot more muffled, whereas compared to the Riverside test... Okay, so I'm recording in both Riverside and Zoom. That's a much better recording. And I did also say we were going to compare the noise reduction in the recording as well. I've done a recording with the noise reduction turned off, and you can actually see all of the noise down here in the recording. Let's have a look at this. And here we are doing a noise reduction test with noise reduction turned off. And you compare that to the recording with the noise reduction turned on. Okay, here we are doing a noise reduction test with noise reduction turned on. I think that's a really good result. And if you were to try and do something like that over in Premiere Pro with just their built-in denoiser, here I'm going to select the one with the noise left in and turn on reduce noise. I'll just go with the default settings. It's a lot more muffled than the one coming out of Riverside. And here we are doing a noise reduction test with compared to this one here. Okay, here we are doing a noise reduction test with noise. And so again, unless you're the sort of person who likes to go over to Adobe Audition and remove the noise there, I would recommend turning that setting on because I think it sounds better than playing around with the denoiser in Premiere Pro. And that's it, that's Riverside FM. Like I said, I recommend it to all of my clients. And if you're thinking about using it, be sure to use that 15% off membership using the coupon code in the description below. Until next time, thanks for watching. Thank you.